Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. We're gonna start from some new game announcements, but also we're going to start from talking about Jeff Minter, because this dude is in some crazy ass games, and as the time progresses, the game's getting weirder and weirder. He already released Polybius on PlayStation VR and his latest addition was Minotaur Arcade, which contain Grid Runner and of course GoTab. GoTab, what a strange game. Highly recommend pick up Minotaur Arcade when you get a chance, but this is in the background playing for you Moose Live, and this is going to be part of Minotaur Arcade Volume 2. Now, in Moose Live, as you can see, you playing as a weird moose and you can run on the floor, but also on the ceiling. This video showcases ramming mode, so if you fan of good old ramage, then you might enjoy this one. Now, he's on Twitter been talking lately that he's planning to have his next game releasing on PlayStation VR as well, so I think, I'm assuming he was talking about Minotaur Arcade Volume 2. If you like his work, if you enjoy all of his games, then you probably gonna enjoy this one as well. To me, looks very fun. Just like most of his games, it looks like a crazy arcade action with a lot of trippy stuff on the side. So I'll be looking forward to playing this, and also I'm wondering what other game will be on Minotaur Arcade Volume 2. His brain got some crazy ass ideas and I really like it. But anyway, enough of that, now let's speak about some other stories and let's speak about some release dates. On December 11th in Europe, Throw Anything will come out, so this is out on PC already, it was out for ages. It's using this low poly asset set, what you maybe saw in Just In Time Incorporated. But this is a different kind of game, because in this game the zombies are coming for you and your idea of survival is throwing shit at them and killing them. You are a part of a government agency and you just gonna do the missions what you have to do, but of course the main thing is to have tons and tons of fun by messing up zombies with a lot of objects. But of course, apart from throwing shit at zombies, you will have some guns at your disposal, so make sure you got those as well. But of course, if all fails, you're gonna destroy all the furniture in the room in order to keep zombies. They be climbing up the walls because they want your brain. So on PC, this game got 6 stages, but also it's got 5 mini bosses and 6 very powerful main badass bosses. And also on Steam, it's got quite positive reviews, so even though it don't look much, it might be a lot of fun. Now, regarding the price, I'm not sure how much it will cost, but PC version cost under Athena, so I'm expecting to have the same on PlayStation VR. Okay, in a minute I'm gonna tell you some more release dates, but first of all I want to talk about the Nostos and give you the latest about this game, because the developers said that this game will be coming to PlayStation VR as well. PC version come out first, but sadly this game is shite, looks like it, because people didn't enjoy it at all. There is some problems with matchmaking I'm hearing, but also what I'm hearing and what is concerning for PlayStation VR owners and also Quest owners, because the developer said this game will be coming to Quest as well, is the fact that this game is super badly optimized and people having problems to reach 60 frames per second on super, super powerful PCs. So just keep in mind that the port of Nostos still might be a while away before it comes to PlayStation VR, and people saying this current version of the game, what is out now, it kind of plays like early access version, so it looks like the game will need a lot of updates. Even UI system and interaction in virtual reality, apparently they got that wrong, which is terrible because it's supposed to be a standard now. You know, we saw many years into the VR that developers should have these things nailed from the straight day one release day, but sadly developers of Nostos had some problems, so even interacting with this game apparently is shit. I was going to buy it on PC and play it and do some previews and stuff, but then after watching reviews and also after watching live streams, people playing it, I really saw how bad this game is at the moment. Now, I cannot talk about flat version, maybe that's good, I don't know, but as it goes for VR version, there is a lot of work needed to be done, Nostos was one of them games what looked very, very promising and sadly it didn't deliver. It's happened a lot, but also from what I'm hearing, there is potential in this game. Basically, it looks like they rushed it out and didn't finish the game, which is the worst strategy they could have done, because now the reviews popping up and people hating it. So just keep in mind that Nostos, when it comes to PlayStation VR, first of all, it might be ages away if they cannot even optimize PC version. Or maybe PSVR version might be this powered through version which gonna run at super low resolution and looks super bad and plays bad. I don't know. But if you was hyped for Nostos because it looks great on trailer, as many times happening lately, trailers are amazing. Sadly, when it comes to actual game and actual gameplay, I'm hearing it's a very big shit show at the moment. So just keep that in mind and not be hyped at all for this game anymore. But I will keep you updated if they improve the game when it's coming and stuff like that. So stay tuned to the channel. Okay, I promised some more release dates, so let's speak about those. Angry Birds Level Editor will come out on 12th on December. Now listen, if you want to try it, download it on the day when it comes out, because this will be for free, but only for limited time, and after that time it will be as a DLC, so people will have to pay. So remember, on 12th of December, if you like your Angry Birds game and you want more levels and stuff and just piss about and make something new, then make sure you update the game and then you're gonna have your level editor. It's gonna stay for free for a bit, but then it's gonna cost money, so make sure you first do it. Angry Birds for me is a fun game. When it's first released, it didn't have that many levels, but then they released some DLC packs with new levels for totally free. I'm glad that they're releasing this for free, this level editor. Sadly, it's only for limited amount of time, but nevertheless, have to take this to the developer that they do support in this game, which is nice, because many people like this game. Angry Birds can't go wrong, and in VR it feels even better. Okay, another release is something I touched a bit before, but I was thinking it's only gonna come out in Japan, but it's not, suddenly it's changed. It's Homestar VR Special Edition, and this is coming out in Europe as well, just like from anything, so if you're in US you won't be able to get those games. Now, Homestar is not too bad, it's like mobile, planetary, observatorium, whatever, nothing groundbreaking. I'm not sure what they gonna do in Special Edition. I'm hearing there will be some more narration and stuff, so I don't expect it to be super improved, but maybe they're gonna improve the graphics, because it felt kind of flat. The sky was above you, you've been standing on the ground, and there was so many 2D assets, and 2D assets always sticking out in VR quite bad. So maybe they improve the graphics in Special Edition. Who knows? Are you excited for Homestar Special Edition? Let me know in comment section if it's something what you've got to have. Okay, next story and next release date. And this release date is Pinball FX2 Ultimate Edition. So basically what's happening is it's gonna be your Pinball FX2 game, but also with all the main tables from the main game. You won't get your Universal Studios DLC and your Walking Dead and stuff, but all the other tables, it will be in this bundle. When the game first released, there wasn't that many tables and then you have to buy DLC, but now you're gonna have it all at once, but keep in mind that all those other bundles, they won't be here anyway. Now, Pinball FX2 is awesome and I really like it, but I wish they released more tables by now. I bought all of them and I don't think I wasted my money, even though I think it's very overpriced for what it is, but also it plays great. So I am enjoying all the tables, they're super awesome, but they also released Pinball FX3, which is only flat, and those tables down there are really nice, like your Star Wars table and other stuff like that. So hopefully, maybe eventually that will become to VR, I don't know. In past they said that if there is a demand they might do it, but they said as well, you know, porting stuff to VR, it's not as easy as flicking a switch and it's all in VR, but also it needs a lot of work to be done, and maybe they don't have resources, maybe the game didn't sold good enough, I don't know. But I do hope we're gonna see some more tables, because many people enjoying Pinball FX2. It's a great game, so we just want more of it. Okay, and last story, I don't want to spread any rumors or nothing, but Dirt Rally, I want to talk about that, Dirt Rally 2.0. Now, as we know, it's got VR mode on PC, but not on PSVR. And as we know, with first Dirt Rally, it's come to PSVR ages after PC version, like nearly a year. So what's happened is, the Codemaster are teasing something for next year. This teaser, it plays for you in the background. Now, what it is, I don't know, I'm just hoping, maybe it's VR, but take it with a grain of salt. I totally don't know at all, but just want put it out there just in case, because as VR mode works on PC, maybe it's gonna come to PlayStation VR next year, who knows. We just gonna have to wait and see what this announcement gonna bring, but Dirt Rally, one of the best racing games on PSVR, also one of not that many racing games on PSVR. I appreciate this game a lot for what they did. It's come out quite early in PlayStation VR life cycle, I think like 6 months after release, and I don't think it's had enough appreciation because people was expecting to get more and more racing games, you know. People was thinking we're gonna get Project Cars and Assetto Corsa and shit, but this never happened. So I definitely appreciate what Dirt Rally did, but I do hope that maybe we're gonna get Dirt Rally 2.0. Who knows, that would be nice. But anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.